YouTube, man, what's good with y'all boys, man? It's your boy Hot Tall, and I'm back with another video today, man. As y'all can tell by the title and the thumbnail of this video, man, I will basically be explaining to y'all what I've been doing while I've been gone, man. I've been gone for, I think, a month, man. It's been a long, long time, but we're back being consistent on this channel, man. As y'all can see, we're back with a new video, and the quality isn't there. Today, I'm recording this off of my phone, but bear with me. We're gonna upgrade the quality. Hey, I got you. But appreciate y'all food. Appreciate everybody who's been subscribing while I've been gone and everything like that. Has been a month, man. I'm not gonna lie, while I've been gone, a lot has been going on with this rebrand. I haven't been gone, just not been doing anything. Kind of been waiting on a couple things to set in line. I've been taking notes. I'm gonna tell y'all how to rebrand y'all brand, man. So y'all, I'm about to tell y'all what I've been doing while I've been gone. So long story short, I've been taking notes, trying to learn more about this brand stuff every single day of a rebrand. So basically with my rebrand, I took a month or 2 months. I think it was a 2 month period without dropping any clothes. I did market a jacket just to try to keep my algorithm going, but it kind of didn't go anywhere. So that is what I did learn. I did take advantage of influencer marketing. I'm gonna pop a couple of people up on the screen right here while I'm talking. I got SRT Joey and a shirt. I got Lil Perfect Labs and a shirt. And I think the last person I did get was V-Long. I watched his vlog channel. His vlog channel is like V-Long BTS. So yeah. Oh, High Off V-Long, that's his main channel. So those are the three people I did get in my shirt that I did have just lingering over a little bit. But what I have been rebranding and everything like that, I was trying to focus on getting products off of my hand, getting them out of my hand and everything like that. So how I did that was I did influencer marketing. I got to a pop-up. I was supposed to go to another pop-up, but while not making it to other pop-ups, I was still trying to get my brand known, going places where influencers were, giving them items. And that's where I gave SRT Joey a shirt. I met him at like a car event, because I'm really big into cars and everything like that. But anyways, so when it comes down to rebranding, make sure you're always trying to get out there, get people to see your brand, because the more people see your brand, the more value your brand has and everything like that. So that is what I would say to do. And make sure you're trying to stay consistent on posting, whether that's TikTok. I posted more on TikTok than I did Instagram, because I kind of didn't want to flood my Instagram with just spam videos to mess up my niche, mess up my algorithm and everything like that. But that is one thing I did, and I did take a couple of notes, so I'm gonna go off my notes. Another thing I did while I was rebranding my brand, as I keep telling y'all, man, I took notes every day, was trying to learn more and more about this brand stuff every day. So I'm gonna tell y'all what I've learned and everything like that. If y'all keep seeing me look to the left, it's my notes that I always been taking. So this is my rebrand notes that I did write, and basically shout out King Euro, man. Most of this stuff has been from his channel, man. So let me just explain this to y'all my way. So what I did, number one, I got a drop prep. So basically you need a product that's very important that people want, that's a wow factor, that's gonna bring people in, that's gonna get eyes on your page. That's one thing I've been trying to like learn about, trying to figure out more ways I can bring more people to my page, give them a reason why they should buy this item or anything like that. So yeah, making sure you got a wow factor when it comes down to rebranding. Make sure you follow up your rebrand with a crazy product that's gonna be like, okay, I need this. Like, you want people to say they need your product when they got it. And my thing that I have already started doing, I want to do pre-made only, because everybody knows in the brand community that pre-order is the fall of all brands. Everybody gets called a scammer. Me personally, I haven't got called a scam. I haven't reached that point yet, and I don't ever want to reach it. So yeah, I'm strictly focusing on pre-made. Another thing I have been thinking about and studying is content ideas. I've been watching a lot of TikTok lives, man, where they mostly talk about content. Content is gonna take you to that next level, especially when you're rebranding. Make sure you study content, like what's gonna go, what's not gonna go, and always try something. Like, don't be afraid to try it, because if you try it, it may work for you. If you don't try it, it's just on you not to try it. So try new things out. Make sure you try a new editing style. Make sure you maybe try to do a fit of the day with your brand. Maybe try to edit like Stephen Womack or anything like that. Just try content ideas, whether it's skits, modeling, photo. So the next thing on my list, I would say make sure you're always doing influencer marketing. Make sure you find people that's still in the fashion world that likes clothes and in your niche. When I say your niche could be fishing, it could be rap, it could be anything that you like your brand to be associated with. So for instance, I like my brand to be associated with cars, fashion, well obviously fashion, lifestyle. Like, I don't really know how to explain it, but I know what my niche is. I found my niche and I want it to be just this niche. Make sure you're always trying to find new influencers that's in your niche, get in a product, see if they like it or not. And if they like the product, that's gonna boost you, they're gonna wear it. You could clip it, put it on your page, then you got one. You got some help behind you. And then that makes your brand more valuable. It gives it more credibility. My fault, y'all. But it gives your brand more credibility. So people will be like, okay, he got so-and-so in his brand. I might actually cop. He got so-and-so in his brand. He's not gonna actually scam me. So that's how I look at it. Make sure you're getting people with names in your brand, because that's gonna also help you grow your brand. And with growing your brand comes growing you, growing your personal brand. So yeah, that's what I would say. And then the last couple things I got on my list. One, I would say, while you're rebranding, make sure you're growing your SMS, bro. Because your SMS is gonna always be a returning customer. Always a returning customer. With returning customers, it brings more people in. It shows the value of your brand, and they're always gonna come back. You got them on like that. Like, you got them coming. Got them, they always gonna come back. Even if they don't buy here, they always looking at a text. They always gonna see the email. They always gonna see something from your brand. So that's giving them more chances to cop from you. So yeah, that's what I would say. Email, I would say SMS. My personal favorite thing that I like to do is SMS. But I do send like emails out, but it really depends, because younger people don't really check their emails unless it's like a little percentage of younger people that do check their emails. For me, instead, I do check my email. No, for sure, my girlfriend checks her email. So it really depends on who you really marketing to and may check the email. Because you know people always, that's one thing I would say. Then the last thing is having great customer service. With great customer service comes a SMS subscriber, comes more people that's going like your brand, see your brand, everything like that. I don't know if I said this already, but another thing I will say is make sure you're going outside, networking, trying to get people to see your brand, whether that's pop-ups, going to events, anything under the sun. Get your brand out there, get your name out there so people can match a face to a brand. That's gonna help you out in the long run as well. So that's a couple of things I've been doing to market my brand and the process of me rebranding my brand and where I've been for the past month of not posting on this channel. But I'm gonna get back more consistent on this channel, man. I'm sorry I've been gone for so long. I really do appreciate everybody who has been subscribing while I've been gone. Got a new banger coming today whenever y'all see this video, then we got another video after that, because I don't know if y'all see what's behind me, my right, y'all left, whenever y'all watching this. But I'm gonna get back to it, man. So make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe on the video, man. It's your boy Hot Tyler, and I'm out.
I'm a little taller, my niggas think I'm living lavish. I can't talk about that body. They like, what happened? Wipe his nose, just give him a nap.